Hi, I'm Mrs. Charles, and it's great to see you again for another I Spy Science and Wired for Science activity. Today we're going to see how a solid can act like a liquid when we make a ball using balloons and rice. It can either be a stress ball, or you can play with it like a hacky sack. To make the hacky sack balls, or stress balls, you need a funnel. I made my own out of a bottle. You need a cup, you need rice, a pen, a scissors, and you need four balloons. I'm using three of one color, three red and one yellow, and you can use any color combination you'd like. The first thing you need to do to do your hacky sack is blow up your balloon several times and stretch it out. Then stretch the neck of the balloon over the top of the funnel, like this. And then when you turn it upside down, the balloon body will hang like that. The second part could get a little messy, so put a cookie sheet, or I'm using the tray, put it under your work area, or you could do this outside. Fill your cup with a little bit of rice, not too much, and then you're going to use the cup to fill your funnel. So you pour it in your funnel, and then if it doesn't go in the balloon easily, you can use your pen to push it down. Remember, don't use too much. You don't want to fill the whole balloon. You just want to fill the bottom portion. Okay, remove the balloon neck from the funnel. And you will need help from an adult to help you tie the knots and layer your balloons. You're going to tie the knot close to the ball. So I'm going to go like this. Make a knot. Okay, there it is. Now I just have to get it off my fingers. That's why you need help from an adult. And this is about perfect because there's a little space between the ball of rice and where the knot is. Now you need to pull it and take a scissors and cut it close to the knot without cutting the knot. So there you have it. Okay, now cut the neck off two other balloons. Notice I'm using the same color. So I'll cut this neck off this one, and this neck off this one. Okay, have an adult put the rice-filled balloon into the stretched-out balloon with the knot going in the bottom of the stretched-out part down there. So it goes down like that. And you push it in, and you just pull it like that. Now you have two layers of balloons. Now you do the same thing with the other balloon, and you're going to put where the bottom edge is loose here down into this one. So I'm going to stretch this one out, and I'm going to have someone else help me turn that balloon and put it in like that. Now take your fourth balloon, that's another color, this one's yellow, and cut off the neck and the bottom. So you're going to cut off the neck. I'm actually going to cut it quite a bit off on one side and then turn it over and do the rounded side. I'm going to cut quite a bit of that rounded side off so that I'm actually making a stripe for the red balloon. Now you can see it's not very even, so you can try and make it straight as you can. There we go. So now I have a stripe that can go over the middle of the balloon. And you want to catch that strip that's loose, this one, in it. So I'm going to hold this open, and I'm going to have my helper hold it so I can put this right around the middle, like that. And there you have a striped hacky sack or stress ball. As you can say, I made several different sizes and shapes, and they all sort of turn out egg shape. The first one I made it larger, and it's so packed in, I can barely squeeze it. That doesn't work as well as the next one. And then I made a third one. And now this one I think is the best because it's the smallest and it's much more squeezable. Okay, what's the science for this? Well, the rice or the flour or the salt, whichever you use, acts like a very thick fluid or liquid. It moves and flows, but it does it very slowly. The rubber from the balloons keeps the rice inside, and since it acts like a liquid, the balls don't bounce very well, and they're harder to use as a hacky sack than a looser bean bag, but they really are fun to play with. Okay, to make this an experiment, you could try using different amounts of rice, or try flour or salt, and then you could also think of your own different filler ideas to make other balls. Now remember, control your experiment only by changing one thing at a time. I hope you liked making the hacky sack, and I hope you spend some time playing with it, or them. Expect that you'll have to practice a while before you can do good footwork with the hacky sack. You could even make more and try to learn how to juggle. Of course, you'd need to be patient and have a good sense of humor. If you're finding it really hard to foot or hand juggle, you can always use it as a stress ball. See you soon with another science activity.